What's going on, everybody? Bert Byler back with another Country and Americana reaction video. Now, I've been hearing so much about this man. So many of y'all have been recommending him. He also has a new album that I'm dying to check out. So let's check out Charles Wesley Godwin, Seneca Creek. But before we do that, if you were wondering how you could support this channel, the best way to do it is to join our monthly membership, which you can go check out at BertByler.com/join. And for the month of November, I'm offering a free month. If you type in free month as a coupon code, you can sign up to our membership, try it out, see if you like it, join our Discord, hang out with the Diesel, a lot of fun stuff. Go check it out at BertByler.com/join, and let's get into it. Guitar sounds so good.
In the spring of 1949, that's when I crossed the county line. And there I saw in Seneca Creek a girl named Ruth who washed her feet.
All right, now.
I told her my name was R.C. Ferris, that I'd marry her with half a carat. She said I do, but no stone can reach the prettiest shine of this here creek. The mud was deep and the roads were wide. We'd retreat and then retake the lines. Korean winters had torn me down and killed all the boys from my hometown. But I'm coming home, Ruth, my dear. I got money in my pocket, don't you fear. We'll build a life by Seneca Creek. You'll have everything you'll ever need.
Now, a lot of folks have been telling me how serious of a deal this guy is, and I can immediately tell it. One, from the lyrics. Two, from just that, just profound, powerful vibe he gives off. He ain't doing much show. He ain't playing nothing fancy. He's got a few chords in the truth, like we like it around here. And he's talking about tough, tough subjects, like folks going off to the Korean War and losing almost all of your friends from your hometown. And it's just so good to see young folks like this who are writing such deep songs, right?
Let's build a home by Seneca Creek.
Yeah.
And raise ourselves a family. I'll work on the farm, you'll work the store.
What a voice.
We'll have everything we'd ever hoped for. With the top of a mountain above our heads and the roar of Seneca by the bend. Seneca Creek.
When he hit them high notes on that chorus, though, his voice is butter.
And sure enough, the hard times came. You loved yours, I did the same. We made it through the winter's cold. In many summers, young and old. In 85, the creek did rise, but it only took the other side. The Gandy nor Forkins, South Branch too. The house still stood that I'd built for you.
Take me to that chorus, man.
In 94 when you got sick, we'd make up trips for the hell of it.
I knew somebody was gonna die.
Take my hand, Ruth, my dear. I'll take you back to any year. And now you lie on the hill up high, right beneath the mountain sky. Seneca Creek sings below. Atop the trees sits a lonely crow. We built a home by Seneca Creek and raised ourselves a family. I worked on the farm, you worked the store. We had everything we'd ever hoped for. With the top of a mountain above our heads and the roar of Seneca by the bay, Seneca Creek.
I think this is just the perfect example of you don't have to be fancy. You don't have to do things that call people's attention. You write a great song, you sing it, and you play it well. And then you have lyrics that really hit home. That's all I need in life, y'all. That's all I need. I ain't asking for Chris Stapleton all the time. I'm just asking for honest folks singing real songs, and that's what this is. And as I was listening to that the entire time, I was feeling challenged to stop wanting more. I don't know if you guys feel like this. Here in America, we have been taught to always want more. We always got to buy more, always got to have more. And I, as he was singing, I just was thinking, like, I own a house with my wife and son and little dog Willie Boo Boo. I live close to my family. I have a job. I have everything that I need. And whenever he got into the part where she got sick, I was like, man, I am going to live today like it's my last, because you never know what's going to happen tomorrow. And so this song was super powerful, and it really hit me to, hey, enjoy what you got and live your life. Be happy. And so what did you guys feel about this song? How did you feel about it? What was your favorite part? I think my favorite part was his voice, his sweet, sweet voice when he went to those major chords on the chorus and he got to that F. And he would hit those soft, high notes. Seneca Creek. it was so good. Thank y'all so much for recommending me this song. I can't wait to check out his record if you made it this far. Thank you so much for watching this video. I appreciate it. Hit that like and subscribe button. If you haven't come hung out with us yet, every Tuesday we do a live stream on Twitch. It's 6 p.m. Central Standard Time where we listen to music. I sing a little bit sometimes, and it's just a great time. I hope y'all have a great rest of your day, and I'll see you somewhere on down the road.